Jangan rasa lovers, selamat siang rasa lovers. Today is Wednesday. It is the first snow in autumn 2020. Jadi ini hari Rabu 21 Oktober 2020. Ini musim gugur, tapi ini salju pertama kali ya. Okay, so today I'm going to make chicken curry. Jadi curry ayam, but this chicken curry a bit different, so adapted from Indian cuisine. Jadi dia terinspirasi dan diadaptasi dari masakan India. Udah not so similar, but it's okay. For this cuisine, this chicken curry, I use garam masala homemade. Jadi untuk ayam kari ayam ini, saya menggunakan garam masala buatan sendiri ya. I ever share you the recipe how to make your own garam masala in my playlist culinary in my YouTube. And then we also prepare 2 big of tomato. Jadi 2 tomat besar. If small, then make it 4. I mean if medium. Kalau medium tomatnya, maksudnya kalau sedang itu 4 aja. Kemudian I use around 3 upper leg. Ini ya. Not, but without drumstick. Only 3. I cut into like this. Jadi ada 4 paha ayam atas. Tapi yang bukan yang drumnya itu ya. Jadi saya potong-potong. Kemudian this is ginza or how to say, this is coriander leaf. Coriander leaf. I don't have fresh one. Somehow I couldn't find 3. So I use powder. Jadi bubuk, bukan bubuk ketumbar. Ketumbar, daun ketumbar atau daun koriander ya, pakai yang kering aja. And then 2 onion, 2 medium onion, I cut into cubes like that. 2 bombay sedang, saya potong kotak. Kemudian 3 siung bawang putih, 3 cloves of garlic. I chop like this, mash and chop. 3 siung bawang putih saya memarkan, kemudian dipotong. Kemudian apa lagi ya? 1 teaspoon of ginger. I grated ginger. Jadi 1 sendok teh yang saya parut. 1 sendok teh jahe yang saya parut. Kemudian 2 tablespoon of curry powder. Ini 2 sendok makan bubuk kari. 3 tablespoon of cooking oil. 3 sendok makan minyak sayur. 4 garam masala, we will use this only berapa ya, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. Jadi 1/2 sendok teh garam masala aja yang kita udah bikin. Also chicken, ayam. Kemudian 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 sendok teh garam. Kemudian apalagi, 1/2 sendok teh merica hitam, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. Okay, now let's start first. I already preheat my pan. I will change that. Saya akan ganti ya. Jadi supaya bisa kelihatan saya lagi masak apa. Bentar. Here. Oops, very hot. Saya sudah panaskan minyaknya. Kemudian kita tuang 3 sendok makan minyak. Barang. Satu, dua, tiga, 3 tablespoon of cooking oil. Now we are going to saute this first. Don't forget to color this. To saute onion. Jadi pertama-tama kita tumis dulu bawang bombaynya sampai dia harum until smells good. This. Di bawang bombay. Now something good. We are going to saute this until golden brown, sampai dia kecoklatan ya. Now already golden brown for onion, I'm going to put garlic. Oke, kita kasih garlic. I put garlic there, 3 cloves of garlic. Saute, it just smells good. Tumis sampai dia harum ya. And also for ginger grated. Jadi ini masukkan juga ginger. So saute this until with not so big fire until 2 minutes, sampai 2 menit ya. Now already 2 minutes, sudah 2 menit. We are going to put this 2 big tomato inside. So we cook until soft. Jadi kita masukkan tomat 2 tadi ya. Sudah kita potong kotak-kotak. Dan already cut into cubes before. Besarkan sedikit apinya. Just make it medium. Your fire. Masak sampai dia lembut. So cook until it becomes melted. The salt. So this curry, chicken curry is special because I'm going to make how to say, like a prata. It's not prata. By using flat bread. I'm going to make flat bread to accompany my chicken curry later. Jadi, but you can also eat that with rice, bisa dimakan dengan nasi juga bisa ya. It depends on your flavor, but I'm going to make different. Jadi, supaya nggak bosan ya. Jadi, kita yang masak nggak bosan, yang makan juga nggak bosan. Make variations with, of course, with your soup, with your available ingredients. Just cook different with available stuff that you have. Vegetable, any kind. Make curry. Okay, now already soft my tomato. We are going to put curry powder 2 tablespoon. Jadi 2 sendok makan bubuk kari itu ya. Kita akan masukkan karena tomatnya udah matang. We are going to cook this for 2 minutes. Jadi kita akan masak ini selama 2 menit. Aduk dulu, you just stir and then let it cook for 2 minutes. Bubuk karinya enak. Enak banget. Oke, okay, already 2 minutes, sudah 2 menit. Sekarang kita akan masukkan ayam, garam, sama merica. So, already 2 minutes, we are going to put this chicken together with salt and black pepper powder. You can use white pepper powder. Here in Russia, white pepper powder we have, but expensive, very expensive for us. Jadi nggak semuanya ya. Kalau di sini juga jarang, di dekat-dekat tempat kami ini jarang, harus pergi ke supermarket jauh dulu untuk beli merica putih. Okay, so here you stir first. Ayamnya pelan-pelan aja ya. And then we put this one, black pepper powder, salt here, boom. Okay, you stir. And mix well, pelan-pelan aja, you stir. Just slowly, sampai dia hancur. Okay, if already you mix well, you cook until becomes brown. Masak sampai ayamnya udah kecoklatan. After that, we are going to cover that. and then we will let it for a while until 3 minutes. 2-3 minutes. Kalau dia sudah kecoklatan, sudah berubah warna ayamnya, kita tutup, masak sampai 3 menit. Very beautiful color, warnanya cantik sekali. For original recipe, use for big tomato, but I don't want to use that too big because this is full of water. This tomato that I use, kalau rasa-rasanya pakai 4 tomat besar, tapi 2 tomat ini lebih daripada besar ya, dan berair itu udah bagus. Gak apa-apa nanti. Kalau kurang kita tinggal tambahin aja air. I forgot also to mention, but later, about coconut milk. You can put coconut milk, or you can put milk, or you can put sour cream. Kalau di Rusia namanya smetana ya. But you can skip that. You can just use coconut milk. Just one small pack. Or fresh coconut. Coconut, yeah, fresh coconut. Already brown, so I'm going to use aluminum foil because I don't want to make it my pan becomes full of evaporation. Nah, jadi tutup aja pakai aluminum foil. Kalau pakai yang tutup yang ada kacanya itu biasanya beruap, nggak bagus. Okay, so let it for a while, around 2-3 minutes. Tunggu sampai 2-3 menit. For 42 minutes, we stir again here. Make it sure not too big your fire. Jangan terlalu besar ya apinya. Smells very good. Ini enak. Nah, kemudian setelah itu kita tambahkan we open that one and then we give water around 3-4 cup. Three quarter cup. 3/4 cup air, water. 3/4 here, water. Give 1, this is quarter cup, ini takaran 1/4 cup ya, saya bikin 3. Dah, like that, done. And then we stir again. Kemudian kita aduk-aduk. Apinya sedang aja. Because you don't want to make your chicken become dry or bloody still. So I want this chicken become juicy. Jadi masih berair ya, tapi bukan yang berdarah. Tapi bukan yang kering. Jadi di medium kan apinya. And then we cover again and we cook until 10 minutes. Masak sampai 4 menit. We cover again. Already 10 minutes. We are going to mix this. I mean to stir. Jadi kita aduk-aduk ya. And then we are going to give sour cream or coconut milk. Jadi kita kasih santannya. 1 cup aja ya, 1 small cup only. You can use 15% sour cream or 20%. Depends if 25% is more, it thicker. Become thicker. If not, if you don't like too thick, you can choose 15% of sour cream. Jadi semakin dia persennya misalnya 15% sour creamnya kan, itu tidak terlalu kental. Tapi kalau misalnya 20%, 25% itu udah mulai mengental. Oke, I'm going to give sour cream. Like this my sour cream. Okay, I already put here the cream. We stir, diaduk. For fire, make it small. I mean, not so medium. Especially if you use coconut milk, you have to stir. Otherwise, it will be not good. Jadi kalau pakai santan harus rajin-rajin diaduk. Kalau enggak dia akan pecah santannya. Kita gunakan kecil aja sampai dia mengental. We cook until it becomes thickest. Now we are going to put garam masala, around 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala here. I made by myself. If you don't have, you may skip that. But if you're in Indonesia, it's easy for you to find garam masala. Or you may skip that. 1 sendok teh aja. Teras. 1 teaspoon. Not 1 teaspoon. I make it. It should be 1/2 teaspoon. No, it's okay. Kesalahan. Gak apa-apa lah. Should be 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. But it's okay. Since I make by myself my garam masala, so no problem. But better you make it 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. Jadi harusnya 1/2 sendok teh ya. Kalau di resep aslinya itu 1/2 sendok teh. Misalnya ini tadi kebanyakan, tapi sendoknya kecil loh tuh. Okay, we cook until it becomes thickest. Now it's time for us to put. If you use dry coriander leaves, you can put now. Just a pinch of that of coriander leaf for kinza. If in Russia it's called kinza, kinza. But if you use fresh coriander leaves, then put Indian. So to make it fresh. Jadi kalau misalnya menggunakan apa namanya, menggunakan daun ketumbar yang segar, or cilantro, what coriander leaf is same. Nah, kalau misalnya pakai yang segar itu letakkan pas udah mau masak, jadi masih segar, jadi masih kelihatan hijaunya itu. Okay, so this is the final result of my India chicken curry. You can for garnish, you can put again coriander, cilantro, dried cilantro, or coriander powder here. No, not coriander powder. Coriander leaves, dried leaves here, or you can use fresh one. Okay, it's very delicious. I will make soon flatbread recipe after this. Jadi setelah ini saya akan bikin roti ceper ya. Nanti sesudah ini. So to accompany this India chicken curry, I will make flatbread, but later. So I will show you later for the next video. So you must try this home. It's very delicious. Smells very good. I think for 2 big tomato, I think is enough. Otherwise it will be sour. Jadi saya pikir 2 tomat yang besar itu udah cukup, apalagi yang banyak airnya, jadi supaya nggak terlalu asam. Okay, I think that's all for today's recipe. Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, comment, and don't forget to press notification button so you never miss our update video. Jadi jangan lupa untuk berlangganan, kemudian di share, di like, di comment, dan ditekan tombol notifikasinya supaya kamu nggak ketinggalan video-video kami selanjutnya. That's it. Dan ya, Rasen Lovers, sampai jumpa Rasen Lovers. Pakai.